I built this playground of my own, and it had a lot of things, like it was a dream world for me.
Yeah.
So that made people think like, maybe he's not okay in his mindset, so.
But in your mind, you're like, I'm building my own my own world here.
Definitely.
why are you particularly passionate in African science advancement?
In Africa, we have the tendency of looking at ourselves on the downside. Mm-hmm. We don't think we can do it. Probably because we wait for other people to do it for us. Mm. So our science here is not that much recognized. Mm. Say for instance, even now we are taking vaccines from other countries. It's not like Namibia couldn't produce their own vaccines. We have geniuses here in Namibia. We have the people that have been trained to create these kind of things. We have the medicinal chemists. We have the biochemists. Mm-hmm. That's why those programs were introduced. But then we don't recognize it. Mm-hmm. And that incapability of recognizing the science that we have within us mm-hmm. really drives us to adapt to things that we don't even understand at the end. So You can tell me that if a student who did biochemistry in China did the same modules that I do, can create Sinopharm, then someone who's at University of Namibia cannot create it.
Yeah.
So the passion really about African science advancement is just to recognize the science that we have. Because I can give you evidence that we really, especially without even going that broad as Africa, mm-hmm. I can give you a scenario like here in our country, Namibia. Mm-hmm. We have the brains, we have the mindset. Let's start from 2014. Mm-hmm. Joshua Ngamwa came up with a very scientific project that really, really was going to bring change in the networking of Namibia. Mm-hmm. That was when he developed a satellite booster in 2014. And we couldn't give him the necessary attention that he needed at that time. I'm happy now he's kind of like, people are now recognizing it because he just posted last week that he got an investor on LinkedIn. But it has been there since 2014, so why now?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
2021. Well,
the attention is coming late.
Late.
Yeah.
Probably, maybe the patient even, like, if it was adapted by that time, now we're going to talk of it being developed more.
Yeah. Yeah.
But now we are still on the first phase. Then in 2015, we had Gerson Mangan, who also created this social network. It was called the Numbook.
Yeah, I remember the Numbook.
So you see, these are Namibian brains.
Yeah.
Here in Africa, it's not like they. But that if that came up in America, we could have adapted it by now here in Namibia, spending money over it.
Mm, mm.
Of something that's our own could create. Then in 2016 we had Petra Simon with the seamless phone. And probably 2017 I came up with the Shepherd NH7, of course.
Yeah.
So you can see the continuation. People are busy, they're thinking outside the box, but they don't know where to go. They don't have direction, which is even the result of the Shape the Guru initiative, the non-profit organization, is to intervene in this, to clear out this gap. We want our own African scientists, our own African developers and creators to be recognized for their work, and we want to take it to another level because we can.
The capable, yeah, 100%. You know, a lot of the things that you mentioned now, I actually, just with my ear on the ground, I've actually heard whispers, and, you know, the sad reality is that you get excited about something and then naturally the attention dies. Then we get excited about something else, the attention dies. And now that is, unfortunately, it is the culture of just, we get excited, we say good job, but then we don't push you anywhere.
Exactly.
We leave you in that box. So yes, man, that's beautifully put and I agree with you wholeheartedly. But let's talk about your invention. You came up with the Shepherd Energy Saver.
Yes.
What is that all about, man? How does it work?
The Shepherd Energy Saver was I started studying it in 2014.
Mm-hmm.
It was actually just an observation when I came to observe like a fan, and like it was during summer, and I was like, why are our units in the house not finishing so fast? Like they were finishing in winter. Could it be because of the heating elements, or because you know people are bathing hot water.
Yeah.
So I actually started practicing doing those things just to see if the electricity is gonna move. So
yeah.
I'll warm up a kettle, not because I need hot water,
yeah,
but I just want to see if the electricity will move.
Shepherd, this is why the kids back in the day, they was like, you are special, man, because you're thinking differently. When other people are like, man, they're just enjoying the fan. They're not thinking out the box like that, you know. Other people are just like, hey, man, it's hot, it's cold, I'll enjoy the weather. You're thinking, why? Why is it like
exactly
this? So, yeah, walk me through that process. So you started coming up with your own little experiments.
Yeah, so I was like, oh, there is a new appliance added to the electricity circuit.
Mm-hmm.
That wasn't there during our winter. So this must be causing the change.
Yeah.
Which is a fan, of course, because now it's hot, so we turn on the fan. And the moment the fan is turned on, that's even when the electricity is slowing down. So obviously this is the thing.
Mm.
So it actually started with the title of the importance of a fan in a circuit.
Mm.
So that was the first title of it. Then I came to a point now of asking myself, but what is so special in the fan? What is it exactly that is making the fan save the electricity?
Mm.
So that's how I started now trying to figure out like what really, and then in the process I developed this the fan theory. The fan theory is actually about energy circulation. So
mm-hmm.
I started like making a sense out of the fan and
yeah,
how it is saving energy. And then I realized that it is not really the fan, because the fan is so broad.
Mm.
It is the motor in the fan.
Mm.
That is saving the electricity, because itself already, when it is ignited with any electrical energy,
mm,
it starts rotation, which means it starts to produce electricity on its own.
Yeah.
That's why when you switch it off, it won't stop rotating,
yeah,
immediately.
It slows down.
Yes. So probably that's where it developed from. Then I started now focusing on the motor and how can we use the motor to save energy now,
mm,
because this is the central idea.
Mm.
And then I started like relating it to the energy production, say, procedures and all processes. So then I found out like this is how the Shepherd Energy Saver started. So the Shepherd Energy Saver is simply a criteria of saving energy using electrical motors. And
mm,
it's specifically targeting cutting the gap between production and consumption.
Mm.
Because, you know, we are in the world where electricity is needed on a daily basis.
Every minute of the day.
Especially with this digitalization of the world.
Yeah.
So when the world goes digital, this calls for more demand of,
yeah,
electricity. Doesn't matter the source, solar, we talk of hydro or,
yeah,
whatever that it is, whether nuclear or, but still,
we need
electricity.
Yeah.
So this calls for government, this calls for energy bodies to call on, like, oh, so people should come up with new sources of electricity because we need more electricity. But this is causing harm to the environment, because
mm,
the more the sources come,
mm,
the more we are disadvantaging the environment,
mm-hmm,
itself.
Because we try to get it cheaper, and
yeah,
sometimes the cheapest way isn't the most sustainable way.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. That's the point. So the Shepherd Ensever kind of says no to that, because the Shepherd Ensever says we can maintain the same production,
mm-hmm,
but increasing
the
consumption.
Because
it doesn't matter the size of a motor that we put from the production,
mm,
side. What matters is the motor that we put to the consumption,
mm,
side.
So you're just all about the environment, man. It all comes back full circle with your love of the outdoors.
Yeah.
You know, trying to be sustainable with this. Shepherd, you're also an author.
Yeah, probably.
What do you write about, man? What inspires your writing?
So my writing is all about reality.
Is it?
Like I see something and I feel like I can have a voice on this thing.
Uh-huh.
So I feel like the best way to put it is in writing. So currently I have one completed book. It's called Rained Land with a Chance of Love. It's an anthology of poetry. So I compiled a number of poems,
mm-hmm,
and then, yeah, I analyzed them and all that, then I compiled this book.
Where can we get it?
So probably we are still saving up for production,
okay,
so that it can be published, but
yeah,
it's done,
yeah,
like everything. We just have to publish it, and
okay,
it's in that process.
Okay.
Yes.
Awesome. And finally, Shepherd, What are your plans for the future, man? Like, as a young Namibian science enthusiast, and there's a lot of enthusiasm coming from you, what are the plans for the immediate future?
So The first thing is, of course, continue working on the Shepard NH7, which is under patent with the Davison in the United States of America.
Okay.
So, yeah, that one is in the process as well. We're still looking for more investors and more partners, but probably we have the mission, so we'll definitely have to complete it. But currently, the more focus is on SDGI, which is the Shape the Guru initiative. This one, it's a non-profit organization, as I mentioned earlier, and this really is inspired by the thought in me to say I should a bit divert from inventing ideas to inventing inventors.
I like that.
Yeah, because I want to clear out this notion of we can't do it. Yes, we have the brain, but we can't do it.
Yeah.
Because we definitely can. So I want to focus much on that one, like call upon investors, then partners, so that we start working on developing African science, which is just like any other science, because science is science, remains that.
Yeah.
So we just want to take it to another level. We want to bring out these young people with ideas. We go in the field. Actually, our motto and slogan is extracting science that works. So we are going to extract science. Yes, we know there are bodies like UNDP, etc. They help innovators, creatives, and all that. But the problem is they wait for innovators to come for them. And these innovators don't know about them.
Yeah.
So as we go in the field,
bridging the gap,
we tell them to say, we have noticed or we've heard, oh, this thing that you're doing is so nice and we feel like it can bring change to the world.
Yeah.
So here's what we're going to do. We know a company that might feel the importance of this project of yours. Like, for instance, if Joshua Ngamo could have invented the satellite booster in the time of STGI, what would we have done? We'd go to him, we tell him, say, Joshua, you've noticed you have this thing. And this would definitely work in the telecommunication. So we got MTC. We have this guy. And he has this idea. So we want to help him patent this idea. And once he gets the patent, we want you to invest into it, develop it, or you can he can either get the license and then you trade on this on his license. Start distributing this satellite boosters.
It's literally just bridging the gap between investors and the science and the creators.
Yes, exactly.
For people that want to get in touch with you, I mean, they either investors or former like fellow inventors as well. Where can they get in touch with you?
So yeah, I have a page on Facebook. It's Shepard M Nyambe. You can find me there. Also on LinkedIn. I prefer LinkedIn most because it's more professional.
Yeah.
And I'm Shepard M Nyambe also there. And people can communicate with me via email at shepardmn01@gmail.com.
And there you have it, man. We appreciate you so much. And I love the enthusiasm, man. And the thing that really warmed my heart in all of this is the sustainable side of what you're trying to do. I'm all about science that is sustainable. And because there's a lot of going back we need to do with science because there's a lot of damage that we've done. And for that, you are our game changer of the day. Thank you so much for joining us, man.
You're welcome.
And that is Shepard Nyambe. Please do get in touch if you are an investor. Do get in touch if you are a fellow science enthusiast. And if you are just someone that understands the need for Africa to A, be self-sustainable, and B, also create a self-sustainable environment for science to thrive. We're diving back into the kingdom. It is Travis Scott with Highest in the Room. Up next on your Inspiration Station.
News Trend, your 1 minute global. Yes, that's global and local news update on 99FM.
Welcome to News Trend. I'm